Unknown to many, there is an active volcano in Southern California, hence these degassing fumaroles and mud pots which are releasing carbon dioxide, sulfur dioxide, and hydrogen sulfide. These gases being emitted originate from a still active and partially liquid body of magma that exists at several miles depth beneath the southeast corner of the Salton Sea. This magma has heated overlying ground to such an extent that it is utilized via 11 active geothermal power plants to generate electricity for more than 400,000 and soon by 2027 up to 705,000 homes. Thus, with such a vast energy source located underground, you might be curious why, if you look around, that you do not see a towering nearby stratovolcano or obvious central volcanic vent. The reason for this is that the volcano in question, known as the Salton Buttes, is one of the smallest volcanoes on the entire planet by both area and volume erupted. However, small does not mean less dangerous, which is why I present to you the fascinating story of the Salton Buttes volcano, whose highest point is 131 feet or 40 meters below sea level. Yet, due to the topography of the region, this is not a submarine volcano existing entirely on land, although I must admit that these spectacular geothermal vents being shown here were all underwater up until 2006. As an overview, the Salton Buttes volcano contains a dispersed group of five small lava domes which formed in three separate volcanic eruptions which all occurred within the last 3,000 years. Lava domes are a distinct type of volcano created by incredibly viscous flows of lava which are unable to travel very far from their source and thus pile up around the erupting vent to naturally form a steep sided dome of material that can grow to be as much as hundreds or even thousands of feet tall. In the case of the Salton Buttes, these five lava domes were all constructed out of rhyolite lava, the most silica-rich and viscous type of lava that exists on our planet. In other words, involving a type of lava 2,500 times more viscous than a typical basaltic lava flow produced by Hawaii's Kilauea volcano. The aforementioned five lava domes have quite a small volume altogether, but each formed in explosive eruptions. Mullet Island was the first lava dome to form in a weakly explosive eruption in 950 BCE, only to be followed 40 years later by the formation of the magnificent Obsidian Butte lava dome in 910 BCE in a more explosive eruption that likely even generated pyroclastic flows. Then, possibly involving two closely spaced separate eruptions or one continuous longer eruptive sequence, the North Red Hill, South Red Hill, and Rock Hill lava domes all erupted in the year 200 CE. This last sequence was also fairly explosive, likely registering on the Volcanic Explosivity Index as a 2. While no eruptions or shallow intrusions of magma have occurred in the years since, this area has remained quite seismically active, generating frequent earthquake swarms in association with an area known as the Raleigh Seismic Zone. This zone marks a major tectonic plate boundary between the North American plate to the east and the Pacific plate to the west that connects the southernmost extent of the San Andreas Fault to the Imperial Fault. This entire zone serves as a pull-apart basin related to the motion of these two tectonic plates, allowing for occasional batches of magma to rise into the crust, interact and mix with ancient solidified granitic intrusions, and then erupt as rhyolite lava. Any future eruption of this complex would also be explosive, primarily due to gas having an incredibly difficult time escaping absurdly viscous lava. Thus, the gas would build up in pressure until a cracked overlying rock, exploding upwards, generating a plume of ash and pyroclastic flows. Falling and ejected pumice would also be a hazard within a mile of an erupting vent, and ash accumulations thick enough to cause problems, and possibly even damage could occur up to 5 miles away from an erupting vent. These hazards combined with the more than 2,500 people that live in the hazard zone of this seemingly small volcano are why the Salton Buttes is classified as a high-threat volcano. As a final note, I would like to thank this channel's valued long-term supporter, Steve Hunsader, for supporting my work.